Well, local author Anne Hood is well known for her novels like The Knitting Circle and The Obituary Writer. And now she has another book out for readers and knitters to enjoy. This morning, we're welcoming Anne Hood back to the show. Good morning, Anne. Thanks for being here.
So great to see you. Good morning.
Well, you know, I understand that the book that you have out now, Knitting Yarns, it's a little bit different from your other books in the fact that it's a collection of essays.
Yet I did not write them. Actually, 27 amazing writers contributed essays about knitting to this anthology.
Okay.
It's about knitting, but in my belief, knitting is really about life.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's about their mothers that they've lost or loved, their grandmothers, their children, really just about life. And they've done an amazing job.
So I'm sure, too, we'll read a little bit about why they're struggling maybe knitting something or and also struggles in life.
Exactly. And I actually have two or three contributors who can't knit, and they write about that frustration, but of course extend it to what they can do in mm-hmm. life and how knitting reflects things that maybe they can't do as well.
Right. And I just want to say, too, my mom and her book club are just huge fans, and I have the scarf right over there that my mom has actually knitted.
Oh, yay, Mom.
So I'll have to show you after the show. But, you know, they have said that your books are always so emotional. You know, you get so much out of it.
Well,
is the same thing
you.
In this book?
I think so. You know, I just read the book for audible.com. And I had this darling 30-year-old sound engineer. 3 days we're trapped in this booth together. And I kept thinking, this poor guy, we're talking about knitting for three
right,
days.
Right.
He twice had to stop and say, I'm sorry, I'm crying. After I would read an essay, I have to collect myself. And at the end, he gave me this big hug and he said, thank you for putting this book together. And here's someone who would not necessarily be the audience you would expect for
exactly.
a book that talks about knitting.
Right.
But it just hits a chord, you know, when writers use that thing like knitting to find or to plumb the emotional lives of all of us.
I was going to say that story, if that's not emotional, then I don't know what is.
Yes.
Your essays, how were you able to choose those essays and I guess the contributors too?
Well, actually, you know, for years as a knitter, I would sit in the back row of lectures or readings mm-hmm. knitting so I didn't distract the person at the podium. And that back row would be full. I would see Anita Shreve back there knitting Ooh. Or Eleanor Lipman or many of the wonderful writers there. And we would always talk, where's the best place to get yarn here? Or mm-hmm. what are you knitting? Why do you knit? And the stories were always touching or funny or both.
And interested you.
Yes. And so I said, you know, the world needs to hear these stories. And I just started asking writers. And before I knew it, I'm getting emails from writers like Jane Smiley, Ann Patchett, Barbara Kingsolver, saying, please, may we be in this anthology. So I didn't have to choose. I had an embarrassment of riches.
Right. You had a plethora of them.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. And you also mentioned sort of in your foreword
yes.
that some of the stories could almost break your heart, you know, put you in tears. You mentioned one. What about the ones that you said just get you in just a belly laugh?
Oh, my goodness. Well, there's a writer named John Dufresne. I do have three men in it, I have to say. And John
nice.
Dufresne writes about trying to learn to knit. And he's just, you know, clumsy and all fingers. And every beginning knitter or anybody who's failed at anything, I dare say that's all of us, will laugh out loud. Or Elisa Chappelle writes about how she took up knitting to lower her blood pressure and how it raised it because she couldn't do
oh,
it.
No.
You know? So you laugh, you know, along with them.
The ironies and
exactly.
and the successes, I guess, too.
Exactly, yes.
And thank you so much for joining
oh,
us.
Thanks.
And such a beautiful cover,
Isn't
might I
gorgeous?
Add, as well.
Yes. And I do want to say there's five original knitting patterns in it, too. So if you happen to also be a knitter and not just a reader, you'll find an extra special treat in there.
Oh, that's wonderful. And okay. any events that are coming up?
Oh, my goodness. Sunday will be at Books on the Square.
Okay.
There will be three of us, and Helen Bingham, who designed the patterns, is going to bring the efforts, you know, the results of those patterns. So come and meet the other contributors and
probably be inspired too.
I hope so, yes.
Well, good. Anne, thank you for joining
thank
us.
You.
As always, you're always writing remarkable books, so
thank
make
you.
Sure that you all pick up the latest copy of Knitting Yarns. It's going to be available in stores and online.